every situation. Can you just lift your hands and say once again, bless your name in everything. Hallelujah.
You give and take away. You give and take away. My heart is yours to say,
yes, Lord.
Blessed be your name. You give and take away. You give. My heart will choose to say,
Thank you and we praise you. for your good and your mercy endures forever. Lord, at the entrance of thy word, Lord, it bringeth light. Lord, this morning, Lord, we exalt your name, your power, your glory in this house. Lord, we acknowledge you as the Lord of this house. Holy Spirit, you be the center, O Lord, of our, O Lord, everything what we do this morning. Holy Spirit, you take control of our hearts, our minds, O Lord, everything, Jesus. Lord, let our hearts be a good ground this morning as your word is released. Let it come and penetrate to every, O Lord, area where, O Lord, it needs penetration, O Lord. Jesus, we thank you. Your word has the power to set us free. Who the Son sets free, he's free indeed. Lord, I need freedom. We all need this freedom. God, pour your fresh oil from heaven this morning, O Lord, and let none of these words fall into any wayside or a rock, but let it fall into a good ground, O Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Praise the Lord. I was meditating, and I see that I wanted to address a very important topic, and before I go there, this is something, I want to ask you a question. How many of you have salvation experience? Okay. Okay. Can you raise it a little higher? How many have salvation experience? Don't raise it if you do not know it. It's okay. There's no condemnation. If you do not know it, don't raise it because you're good. Okay. Phew. And now that's the reason I was asking. Okay, let me ask in Telugu. Enta mandiki rakshana anubhavam undi? Okay. Good. Praise the Lord. That's why Holy Spirit wanted me to ask this. Because many of you don't have salvation experience. Now, many of us, we are born in Christian families. Okay? It doesn't make us Christians. Because you're born in a Christian family, it doesn't make you a Christian. Let me settle the straight account first. Now, there was a man at the time of Jesus, Nicodemus. And let's go to John chapter 3, verse 3. John chapter 3, verse 3. Praise the Lord. And Jesus, he came in the middle of the night. In the middle of the night he came. And he asked a question. And this was the answer. What question? Can you go to first two verses, please? Now, can we read? Now, okay, that's fine. Second verse. The same came to Jesus by night. That's Nicodemus. He was a teacher. And said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher, come from God. For no man can do these miracles. Now Jesus was doing miracles. He was healing the sick. He was healing the blind, raising the dead. He was doing all the miracles that thou doest, except God be with him. Now Jesus said, Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, always you have to be very careful when it says, verily, verily, assuredly, 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 surely, means it's very, very important. Now Jesus is saying, verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Telugu lo kan chadu read in someone. Now, you will not see the kingdom of God. Nischayamuga cheptaru. Devuni rajyamu chudal. Nischayamuga means today if you die without accepting Jesus Christ as your savior, whoever didn't raise, you will be in hell. Simple. Why? Go to 16th verse, in the same verse. Now, what is salvation? What is salvation experience? Rakshana anubhavam. You see, For every person, that is a day. I was born again on May 5th, 2005. Now that is the day my spiritual birth took place. Everyone should have a date. The day you were born again. Now you see, lot of us, we come. Now this is a question I asked one of the brethren this week. I asked him, are you born again? And he looked at me with a surprise. Now, do you have a salvation experience? Now, if you do not, means, did you encounter Jesus? You see, in the Bible, Paul, who before he was Saul. Saul was a Pharisee. He was a strict Pharisee. He knew the Torah at the time, the Old Testament. Now, he was following God in his own zeal. He was zealot. He was following according to his righteousness. He kept the law. He did everything outwardly, everything, but the heart was never changed. He had a different perception of God. He thought and he went on persecuting Christians. He went on killing Christians. In other way, he was a Christian jihadist. He was killing people in the name of God. Now, because he did not understand who was God in reality. Bible says, those who do not love, they do not know God. Now you see, because God is love. Bible says. Now, many of us, we know God. Now you see, there is so much false perception of who God is, who Jesus is. And I heard and again, they say, oh, accept Jesus, your financial problem will go. Accept Jesus, you will have miracles. Accept Jesus, demons will be delivered from your house. Accept Jesus, you know, there's a wrong motive they came to Jesus. If you see in the Bible, some came to eat, some came to watch, some came to find faults, some came to different for healing. But why Jesus actually came? What is the purpose God the Father sent Jesus to us? Now you see, Christmas is there, the entire world celebrates, they don't understand the meaning. Entire world celebrates Good Friday, they don't understand the meaning. The entire world celebrates Easter, they don't understand meaning. Now you see, the world has defined Christianity in a different way. Now, the same way Saul, he thought he can kill people and he was persecuting the church. We see again and again people came with the wrong motive. Now, this morning, sorry to disappoint you, if someone says, come to Jesus, all problems will finish, it's not Christianity. In fact, the problems will grow in your life. But during this problem, God will give you victory. Amen. That is true Christianity, because Bible says, those who live godly will suffer persecution. Now, there is no shortcut in Christianity. Sorry to disappoint you. If someone told you, they said lies to you. Jesus came to set us free from sin. Now you see, he came to seek that was lost. Jesus came to deliver us from the bondage of slavery of sin and the demon oppression. He came to set us free. He came to set captives free. Now you see, this man, Nicodemus, when he came in the night, he was the law. He was just like Saul. He kept the law. In fact, he was teaching the law. He was the teacher of the law. Now, Jesus said, straight to the point. He said, verily, verily, I say unto you, unless you're born again, means you have to have a new birth experience. Not just because you call upon Jesus, not because you just keep worship songs, not because you come to church, not because you give offerings. It doesn't help. until your heart is changed, until you repent and ask Jesus to come into your life. Now you see, the first entry of becoming a Christian is open your heart and saying, Jesus, come into my heart, and you change my heart. I believe that you died. Now you see, let's read verse 16. Now, why did Jesus come into this world? Now we say, for God so loved the world. Who is in the world? You and me. That he gave only begotten sin. Now, man was lost. When the first Adam sinned, death came into this world. Why? Sickness came into this world. Curse came into this world. Fear came into this world. Everything came with someone sinned. Now, first Adam, because I want to tell you guys, the foundations are wrong. It's like a house. If the foundations are wrong, whatever you build is not going to stand. Doesn't matter, you use the big thing. Whatever the beautiful the house, but the foundation is wrong, it will not stand. Now, you see, we have to know the foundation of your faith. Now, what is the foundation of faith? That Jesus, the first Adam, sinned. And man had a communion. Man had a fellowship with God. Now, this relationship, this communion has been broken because of sin. They were separated from God, the Father. That relationship has been broken. Now, after the promise was given about sending Christ in right in Genesis, that the seed of woman will bruise the serpent. The promise was given, the solution for that sin was given in the foundations, just right in the creation. Now you see, you pray to Mother Mary, doesn't happen. You will not be saved. No salvation is no other name. Now Jesus had to come from heaven. He took the form of a man. Now he has to offer his life for your sin and my sin. Now you see, in every religion, you all know, right? They kill animal. They shed blood. Papa pariharamu raktam chindakinchakunda papa pariharam led. Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sins. Now you see, every time you sin something, you need an offering. Now, but Jesus, man's sin grew so much, now man couldn't afford to give that many offerings. Now you see, if a poor man is sinning, how can he offer? His sin is piling up. But Jesus said, Jesus had mercy. Now God the Father sent his Son. He said, only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but ever have everlasting fire. What is perish? There's a second death. If you reject Jesus, please listen carefully. Today, this morning, what I'm sharing is to matter of life and death. Eternal life and death. So I feel so scared, people who didn't raise your hands. If you did not know Jesus as your Savior, you might be doing all the rituals, all the things. The first thing starts with relationship. Now that comes Jesus sending his Son Jesus to on the earth, and he died for you. You and me, we deserve death. But he took your place and my place. Now imagine, you commit a crime. Now the penalty is death. You stand in the court and the final judgments, judge says, he will have a lifetime imprisonment and you will hang to death. Now suddenly someone comes and your family, everyone is worried now. Your life is done. You are just young, but you're sentenced to death. Now suddenly someone comes and says, you know what? I'll go instead of him. I will take that place. I will go. Please release him. Now imagine the father comes. Please release my son. I will pay the price. That's what Jesus did. You and me, the wages of sin is death, Bible says. But the gift of God is eternal life in Jesus Christ. Now you see, always this is a problem. Because we did not experience Christ. Jesus, we did not invite in our hearts. I have a testimony. I was lost in the world one day. I was lost with the sin, lost with the pleasures of the world. Everything outside was good, but inside I was dead. Now you see, the problem is that heart Jesus never took over. I did not invite Jesus in my heart. Now the first gate of Christianity is you give your life to Jesus. This morning I want to plead you, my brother, you see, but whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Today, you might die without money, you might die in debt, or whatever it might be, but if you have Jesus Christ, you will be with him. That is a hope we have. Amen? So now Nicodemus, though he was a law, he was following everything, but he did not have God. In other words, Jesus said, without me coming to your heart, Nicodemus, you're not going to go to heaven. Now Saul, on the road of Damascus, Saul had a mask of religion. Religion is what? To do, like morning, you wake up, pray, and you read Bible, 1-2 verses, if you are good. Some are sincere. You know, I really am telling you, a lot of unbelievers have more good religion, they keep religion, than you and me. I really like Catholics, they are strict in what they follow, religion. But sadly, they can't go to heaven. Now you see, we all are sinners, fallen short of the standards of God. Now Jesus took the standards. He paid and he gave the salvation. So now Saul, he experienced his mask on the road of Damascus. I heard one of the servant of God said, Damascus, it was a road of Damascus. His religion has to be demasked to experience Christ. His scales had to fall. You see, we see with our eyes the way we want to see God. You see, I was telling healing. Okay, let me give you this example, what I gave this young brother. You go to a shop, you buy a Horlicks. How many of you know Horlicks? It's a milk, yeah? And they say there's a cup free. Okay? Now you go and take the cup. And if you leave Horlicks, yes? Because the cup is so beautiful. You leave the Horlicks. Now that's what is Christianity is. They leave Jesus and they take the healing. And they're satisfied. They take financial breakthrough and they're satisfied. They take deliverance from demons, they're satisfied. But they leave the main product. Every blessing is a byproduct of Jesus Christ. Do you get me? Now, if you leave Jesus, that's why today Christians, they shake when things go wrong. That's why, because the foundation is wrong. It doesn't matter, your windows has a beautiful frame. Doesn't matter, you have a beautiful vessel in the house. What if tomorrow earthquake comes? The foundation is shaken. No matter that expensive, how cross you put the expensive, whatever things, it will go. It's like Jesus Christ is the treasure. Now if you don't have, that's what Bible says. Now in this earthly vessel, we have this treasure. Jesus Christ. In Matti Patrulo Christu Sampada. It's a treasure, is Jesus Christ. So a lot of people, they take the blessing and they leave Christ. To this morning, Jesus is saying, know me. Because Jesus said, I am life. Knowing me is knowing life. Now Jesus says, no one can come to the Father except through me. Jesus says, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. There is no other name. No Buddha, no Rama, no Allah, no other name, but the name of Jesus that will take you to heaven. I boldly declare that there is no other name. You try it. Tell me a person who died for you. Tell me a God who died for you. Jesus died for you. Bible says there is no friend who layeth life for us. But Jesus Christ laid his life for us. Now, salvation, This is what is salvation. You're delivered. The time you say, Jesus, come into my heart, Jesus come and resides into your heart and mind. Amen? So that is what the first step is. Now, once you praise the Lord for people who are saved, now Christian life is a progressive life. 2 Peter 3:18 it says, now we need to grow each day in the Lord. Now it says 2 Peter 3:18 it says, but grow in grace, in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Now this morning I want to ask you, are you saved and stuck? Now you see, Lord of Christianity is like this. Children of Israel, they came out of Egypt. They had the Red Sea experience. Red Sea experience is a baptism experience. Okay? Now, a lot of people get baptized and they're satisfied with it. They are satisfied with it and they halt at the mountain. And they go around circles in the same sin and sin and sin. Now you see, this is what I wanted to highlight you. A lot of times Christians, many of us here, you sin, you repent, you sin, you repent, you walk for some time and you fall again, you sin and you never go forward. You sin, we forgive sometimes, we do not forgive sometimes. We hold up pride sometimes, we humble sometimes. There's no consistency. It's like yo-yo life. One day we are up, one day we're down. Sometimes, you know, Shakespeare. You see, most of us are religious, but not relational. Now, Peter is saying, but grow in grace. What is grace? Every day, what? You have to receive grace from God to grow. How? In the knowledge. How? Through God. Try to know Him. Now you see, they've seen everything, the miracles. The children of Israel, they've seen the miracles, mighty miracles. Now, once they passed Red Sea experience, they didn't change heart. Did they reach Canaan? No. They didn't reach Canaan. Lord, they had every, you see, there are 10 times successfully children of Israel failed. 10 times. The first was fear at the Red Sea. Second was they were murmuring. They were murmuring at the waters of Mara. You see, you go on. They rebelled against God. They died. They complained because there was no water. They complained they didn't have food. Lord of us, we are in that level. We are so, our defeat, we are just satisfied if God gives us salary, God gives us clothing, God gives us a house, God gives us, you know, a job, God gives a visa, or God gives us whatever. Man's need never fulfills. Now you see, don't use God, please. Don't use God. Honor Him. Why do you have to follow Christ? Now, Jesus asked Peter, who do you think that I am? What do people say? And some said, you are a prophet. Some said, you are Jeremiah, prophet Jeremiah. Some said, you are Elijah. Now, Jesus came and said, okay, Peter, that's fine. All others are thinking, what do you think? And Jesus said, Christ means the Savior. You are the Son of the Son of God. You see, we don't have revelation of Jesus Christ. We don't have who God is. That's why our prayers are empty. Our prayers are so earthly. Our prayers are so emotional. Our prayers, today we don't know our authority in God. That's why when time comes, you don't know who you are in Christ. You see, today if I ask, what is Christ to you? You will say, we all say, oh, we've been taught in the Bible, in the church, we grew up in we know the jargons. But in reality, did you have experience like Saul turned to Paul experience? Now you see, Let me tell you. Let's see, read this beautiful experience one man had in Luke chapter 19, verse 8. There was this man named Zacchaeus. Now you see what happens when you really experience Jesus in your life. Yes. What he says, 19th chapter. And from let's read from verse number 1. And Jesus entered and passed through Jericho. I really like pass through Jericho. You know who passed through Jericho? Joshua. Okay. And also another one. Where was the Samaritan man? Yeah? Isn't it? So Jericho is a quite interesting place. There were many wounded people are there. Now Jesus came, passed through Jericho, and behold, there was a man named Zacchaeus. Our little Zacchaeus, he is here. Who was the chief among publicans, and he was rich. Rich in the world, but poor inside the heart. Now you see, the richness couldn't, now he became desperate. Now you see what he says now. And he sought to see Jesus, who he was, and could not for the press because he was a little of a stature. He couldn't see. He wanted to see Jesus, but the crowd was so much so that now he couldn't see at his level of his height. Okay? Now what happens? He ran before and climbed up into sycamore tree to see him. For he was to pass away. Sometimes you have to go to heights to see Jesus Christ. You have to make an effort. See who the Lord was. Now there you go. Then what it says, next verse. And when Jesus came to the place, he looked up. Now you see, Jesus' eyes drew on this man who was desperately seeking. Now you see, you will only find Jesus if you seek him with a true heart. Zacchaeus was desperate to see who Jesus was. Now you see, and he said, and Jesus came to a place and he looked up and saw him. I don't know why did he look at the sycamore tree. And said unto him, Zacchaeus, he knew by name. Jesus knows each one of you by name. You see, Bible doesn't say there was a record. Jesus had a list of names in Jericho. There was a publican. He didn't know. He knew by name. Now you see his name. He said unto him, Zacchaeus, make haste. Means come and come down. Be quick and come down. For today I must abide at thy house. Wow. Now, this Zacchaeus was hated because he is to take tax, he is to put burden, he was cheating, he was doing all the dodgy things, he was doing unfair things to people. Now, and when he came down, now Jesus said, but I want to come to your house. Doesn't matter how sinful you are, people might reject you, people might put you to a side, your neighbors might don't want to talk to you, your family might reject you, but Zacchaeus, but I'm still okay to come. He was a friend of the sinners. Now you see, Jesus seemed different. He came. Now what is it? Make haste and come down. And he made haste. He came down quickly and received him joyfully. He said, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Now people, imagine all the people around him were surprised. By Jesus, this doesn't he know what the man kind of man Zacchaeus was? Now then what happened? Now you see, immediately they're saying, and when they saw it, they all murmured, saying that he was gone to be a guest with a man that is a sinner. Sometimes we are religious people. We point others. He's a sinner. He's a sinner. Oh, do you know his past? Do you know his past? He's a crook. He did this. My friend, you don't know. Sometimes people are forgiven and they move on, but you'll be still standing here judging others. There's a danger. There's a danger how we see people. Do you see? That's what Paul says at one place. When I came to you, we did not regard anyone after the flesh. But in the spirit we see. See, be careful how you judge others. Amen? Now you see, when they saw, now Jesus had a different eye lens than what people were saying. Now you say, they were saying he's a sinner. How can he come and eat at his house? Now Zacchaeus stood and said unto the Lord, he didn't care what others were saying, behold the Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor. Do you see? When he had encounter, that his heart got convicted. You see, when you experience Christ, your heart gets transformed. You will ask forgiveness. You'll be quick because did Jesus preach anything? His love was so full that he realized he was a sinner. Immediately, because he has experienced Jesus, now straight away, he wants to fix his sins. Immediately saying, in other words saying, I know Lord, I've cheated. I know that everything I've done was sinful. But God, from today, okay, I give off of my goods, I give it to the poor, then he doesn't stop there. And I have taken anything from any man by false accusations. I restore him fourfold. Now you see, this is true conversion. Now I want to ask you, did you have this conversion in your heart? When you experience Jesus as your Savior, your life will be changed. You know, once when I was saved, I went and asked forgiveness to all of my friends I hurt. I went, they were shocked. I was too proud. I went and I wanted to settle the accounts. Everyone. Because when Christ comes, your life changes. Your heart changes. Your conviction comes. Because Jesus cannot stay in a heart where there is sin. Now, Zacchaeus, that day his salvation came into his house. Now, what happens? Immediately, Jesus said unto him, this day is salvation come to this house, for so much as he is also son of Abraham. Do you see? What a beautiful thing. What a beautiful. Today, if you accept Jesus, and if you repent, if you know, Lord, I've been fooling around, playing the game of religion, but God, I want to experience what Zacchaeus experienced. Lord, I want to give my life to you. I want to be saved. I want to be saved. You know, when Peter rose up on the day of Pentecost, when he preached, 3,000 people begged him, what shall we do? And they said, what shall we do? They were asking because their hearts were cut. Their hearts were repented. Today, why you cannot forgive others? Why you are so proud? You are arrogant? Because you never had a true salvation experience. When you have a salvation experience, you grow in the grace. You will not condemn others. When you experience grace, what is grace? What you did not earn for, you receive it. The people go to Tirupati, they cut the hair, you know, some people they go, they give blood, they give so much things for the sins, for the sin. They have to. Now, but nothing can take away that sin. Nothing can, we can never earn. Bible says, you do good things, but it will never satisfy God. It will never satisfy God. Our good things are like filthy rags before God. Never our good things. That's why we cannot forgive, we judge others, we blame others, we accuse others, we defame others. We are not, why? Because honestly, when I see, I feel sorry. This person did not experience grace of God. Person did not experience the mercy of God. Now you see, Jesus told a parable. One of the person, he had debts. He had huge debts, and he asked this ruler, and the ruler says, today from today, your debts are forgiven. Now this guy receives forgiveness, he said, in union. Then he goes home, and his servant comes and asks, you know, I cannot pay. And you know what he does? He beats him like anything. You see, if you are truly forgiven, you'll forgive others. If you truly receive mercy, you'll be merciful to others. What is the Lord's prayer says? Father, forgive us our sins as... Amen. As you receive, you do it. You'll not be religious. You'll not condemn others. You'll be gracious. Now imagine God starts putting a finger like this and starts pointing our mistakes. Can you stand? None of us can stand. So how dare you point out others? How dare we point out? Each time the Spirit of God convicts, I said, be careful how you. Because when Christ resides in you, you walk like Christ, you see like Christ, you act like Christ, you're merciful because you experience the grace of God. Zacchaeus experienced, he didn't deserve what he did. Zacchaeus didn't deserve. Zacchaeus knew how sinner you are. That's why today we cannot love God, cannot worship God, because you never experienced Christ in your life. Today, I'm saying salvation. Receive Jesus in your hearts. Now, Zacchaeus, salvation came into his household and his life changed. You see, always, you see, if there are no fruits for your salvation, then really it doubts you're saved. The fruits is forgiveness. Fruits is love. Fruits is, now, can we read the fruits? What kind of fruits you will bear? Galatians chapter 5 from verse 19. Now, someone who is saved, you'll see. Someone who is not saved, these are the fruits. Now, I want you to put your finger to yourself and check your hearts. Now, you see, don't ever think about others. Think about yourself. Now, what it says? Now, 19th verse. Now the works of the flesh are manifest. Now you see, when you're born again, you're born in the flesh. No, we are born in the spirit. Whenever you accept God, you're born in the spirit. You're born in the flesh in natural birth, but your spiritual birth, you're born in the spirit. Right? Now, if you're born in the flesh, if you're still natural, if you're still not still born again, now you see what it says. And B, please examine. Let's examine ourselves. What it says. Which are these? Yeah. Adultery. What is adultery? You are cheating, sir. Isn't it? But there's a spiritual adultery. If you love the world, the things of the world, that is spiritual adultery. Now, see, don't think that, oh, I'm not cheating my wife. No, no, no. But you're cheating God, the Father. When you're loving the world, no, you don't be righteous in your sight. You can be spiritually right, so proud, but when you see from the spiritual, that's why carnal mind cannot understand things of God. When you have spiritual mind, you'll judge yourself in a different way. You see, a lot of times I see in the church is people walk in pride because I'm perfect. Oh, Bible says, be careful who thinks that you can stand. No, no, no. By the mercy of God, you stand. By the grace of God, you stand. So don't ever. That's why you sit in the seat of judgment, judge others. Because you don't see it yourself from the eyes of God. When you see, start seeing from the eyes of God, you judge differently. Now you see adultery. If you're a natural man, straight away you're thinking, oh, physical adultery. No, spiritual adultery. You want me to show you where it says? Bible says in book of James, Do you not know that friendship with the world is enemy to God? Oh, you adulterers. Oh, you adulterers, he said. You're spiritual children of Israel, they adulterated. You know, Hosea's wife, she went each time. And Hosea had to bring it back. What does it mean? That Israel were like that. They were going away to other gods, leaving the true living God. The true Yahweh. They left and they were going to other gods. You see, today, any idol in your life, any idol you're following, a person or a thing or a sin is a spiritual adultery. Okay? Now you see, adultery, fornication. What is? Before God allows you to have that sexual experience with your holy matrimony, you do it, it's fornication. Uncleanness. Watch out. Unclean mind. Unclean heart. If you're not pure to your brother's love, always some people are septic. They talk, some talk, they sarcastic talk. They think something, they mean something. You know? Unclean talk. They're critical spirit. They say something double-tongued. You know, crooked thinking. Unclean. Lavishness. Yeah. Carry on. Idolatry. Witchcraft. Some people want to manipulate. I want my way. I want my way. If that person doesn't go your way, that's it. Done. He's blacklisted. You'll not help him anymore. You'll cross, that's it, the spirit of witchcraft. Because you want to manipulate someone. God is saying, don't do it. God is against manipulation. You know, people who trust God, they don't manipulate things. Because they wait for the Lord's move. Amen? You can't force and let people do. That's witchcraft. That's the spirit of witchcraft. Now, hatred. Variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envy, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and such. Sometimes other gets little praise, you're envy. You make faces. And what you say, and what it says, of which I've told you before, and again, in told you in the time past, which they do such things, shall not. Devuni Rajyamu Praveshim. Period. You can't enter into the kingdom of God. Why? If you're not born again, you'll be doing all these things. Because you don't know Christ, because you do the works of the flesh. Now, if you're born again, if you're walking with Christ, if you're walking in the Spirit each day, if you're submitting to the Lord, to His ways, and then what says? Now you see. But the fruit, you see, now straight away Zacchaeus, there was a fruit in him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now Saul, who turned Paul, straight away he's killing. Now straight away he's proclaiming now. Now look at woman at Samaria. The woman, same woman who was living in sin with multiple men. This woman, next, when she was saved, she was proclaiming Jesus. You see, there's a transformation. There is a change. There's a change of life. Change of actions. Change of... You see, you don't say, my heart. No. Your people will know by the fruit, good works you do. Your light will shine among men. It is the choices. It's the way you treat others. Says how much you know God. You see, if you overlook someone, sin... You see, prema aneka papamulnu kappunu. Love does not count, but love covers multitude of sins. Now you see, that's why it says the first fruit is what? Of a believer is?
Love.
Can we say it?
Love.
Say it louder, please.
Love.
If you do not love, 1 John 5:8. Can you say? I think 1 John 5:8. It says, if you do not love, you do not, there is... What does it say? 1 John 5:8, I believe. 18. If you do not love, the love of whoever does not love does not know God. For God is love. It says. Is it 1 John? Just Google it, please. That's much quicker. No. Okay, for this you can respond. Okay, 1 John 4:8. Can we read together, please? Telugulo chadavandi. Now we say, what does it say? Okay, let's read from 7th verse. Beloved, can we read together? Beloved, let us love one another. For love is of God. And everyone that loveth is?
Born of God.
Everyone that loveth is?
Born of God.
Born again. If you do not love, my brother, you've never been born again. Simple, the Bible says. Born of God and knoweth?
God.
Now, you don't say, I know God, I listen to songs, I act like holy. My brother, my sister, if you're not loving, forget it, avoid it. You don't know it even God. You're judging others quickly. You can't forgive others. You pinpoint others.
Yeah.
If you don't have patience, you forgot. You lost it. You are never born again. Let God be true and let all men lie.
Amen.
You see, you do not know God. Simple. Now you say what it says. Then next verse. He that loveth not, knoweth not God. How beautiful it is. God's word is truth. For God is love. So, if you're not talking to people, please go and talk to them today. If you're not talking to that relative, go and talk. Settle your accounts today. Because God is love. Amen? Then go forward. What it says. Now how God did not just say, I love you to the world. What did he do? In actions. Now, always love is in actions, right? Now, God also shown in actions. How did he show? You see, some people say, you know what? I don't talk to them, but I love them. That another deception. So we are so clever. You know? No, brothers, you see, though I don't talk, but I don't have anything against them. When it comes, you go this way. We fool up. We deceive ourselves. You see, don't you think God is watching? How we are then? God checks the intent of our hearts. God checks. God says, next time you come, God, I love you, I love you. God said, rubbish. You don't even know me. For God is, I'm love. The first fruit is love of the Spirit. Now you see, in this was manifested the love of God toward us. Because God sent his only begotten Son into the world that we might live through him. Then, let's close this. Herein is love. Not that we loved God, but we rebelled against God. We love God, but he loved us and sent his Son to the propitiation of sins. Let's stand in the presence of the Lord. Amen. This morning, I want to say bold declaration. If you do not know Jesus, please let's close our eyes this morning. And if you do not know Jesus as a Lord and Savior, my brother, this is a time. If you do not know, there is a place called hell. That's not a nice place. The wrath of God abides on those who have not believed Jesus. Devan Ugrata. Now that's not a good thing. Today, God is speaking to you. Whatever come out of that sin, I'm here to forgive. Bible says if you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus Christ died and rose up from the dead, that and you ask him to come, you will be saved. This morning, do you want to be saved? Please, everyone, close your eyes. If you have never given your life to Jesus, you might be born Christian in your family since childhood, but if you have not given your life to Jesus, today is the day you have to make this decision, my brother, my sister. Without knowing Jesus, you cannot enter into the kingdom of God. You have to be born again, born of water and born of the Spirit. And this morning, the Lord is speaking to you with such a clarity. Whosoever shall not believe him shall perish. Papapu jitamu maranam, the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life. Today, God's grace is that you are hearing this sermon. Your religion does not take you to heaven. Your good works does not take you to heaven. All your things will not take you to heaven except Jesus. He is the way, he is the truth, he is the life. No one can come. If you really want to give your life to Jesus, please, everyone, close your eyes. It is time. Forget about everything. Today, welcome. You might be following religion. You might be following everything. But if you not receive Jesus in your heart, Zacchaeus, how Jesus came into his heart. He was sinning. But that day when Jesus came, he realized, I'm a sinner. Lord, from today, just raise your hand if you want to give your life to Jesus. For the first time, say, Jesus, I welcome you in my heart. Lord, I confess I'm a sinner. Lord, I have followed religion, but I've never known you as my Savior. Lord, I thank you. Thank you, God, for touching. Thank you, Jesus, for the raised hands. Say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Lord, I give my life from today. Lord, I believe that you died for my sins. You took my place on the cross of Calvary. Lord, you were innocent, but you died on my behalf. Lord, you died and you rose up again. Lord, through you, I rise up. So Lord, from today, Lord, I believe you as the Lord and my Savior. Lord, I accept you, what you've done on the cross. Lord, thank you, Jesus. From today, Lord, I do not follow any other idols. From today, I want you are my Savior. Lord, I thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Today, if you pray that prayer, there is celebration in heaven. And Bible says salvation came to the house of Zacchaeus. Salvation has come into your heart, my brother. Amen. Jesus comes and he wants to live. From today, it's a new life. So congratulations to people who raised hands. Hallelujah. Amen. Father, we praise your name. Oh Lord, that you have done your work, Holy Spirit. Thank you for convicting our hearts of sin. Thank you, Jesus, for this morning. Lord, he who does not love does not know God. May we love one another. May we walk in love before you, Jesus. Not just one another, even with you, Jesus. Father, we praise your name. From today, Lord, let this be a defining day in our lives. Holy Spirit, we praise you. We thank you, Lord, for everything what you've done this morning. Father, help us to enjoy the salvation in our lives, which we received by grace and through faith. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.